I saw in the program of the Potsdam Summer School that the topics are really interesting, very connected among them, and really with a lot of substance.
Me coming as an engineer to this very broad spectrum was very intriguing because I felt like I was missing that part.
So the one part is about enhancing my knowledge, and the amazing another thing is that I am enhancing my networks with very different people all over the world and getting their perspective. So that's very beautiful.
I just want to contribute to build a sustainable future for the next generations, to provide a good environment to the children of my children.
The summer school of the IASS and other research institutions here in Potsdam are there as a learning experience. We have applicants from 30 countries, and we always try to accept from as many countries as possible so that we have a real good international representation. And the goal of the summer school is to provide this learning platform, and we'd like to exchange our knowledge about sustainability with the experience and the specific knowledge of the participants.
I think it is worth just standing still for a moment at the title and see what do we mean by confronting. We need to face the problem. In this context, the massive levels of socio-ecological earth system decay that we are witnessing all over the world. And of course, its associated patterns of intergenerational, intragenerational, and interspecies injustices.
The topic is about sustainable transformations. We chose the topic because we need to emphasize the need for transformations in society to happen. We have the science that shows that the planet is rapidly declining and that ecological integrity is rapidly declining. So we have the evidence, we just need to act upon that.
I think we really need to be ambitious right now. It's not possible anymore to see things separated from each other, and actually climate and nature are depending and are very closely related to what we do as humans. And the energy system is a central part of what we humans are doing on a global scale. So right now we need to see things together and address them together in order to design the transformations and the way to transformations that we are striving for.
For each topic we have enough specialists, but how to make these topics interact with each other, that's something that we would like to explore at the summer school.
How are we going to adapt to the impacts of climate change?
Is there any way we can drive transition from the bottom up and not from top down?
How our societies can transition to another system and not replace the current one with the same but based on other resources.
How can we get the companies to really integrate the social and environmental aspects?
I come from Nepal, where people are still struggling for food security and the basic needs. But I think even with the limited resources, we can make a difference to achieve the sustainable development. And in this regard, my question is, why can't women make a difference?
From an ecosystem approach, sustainability means one thing. From a financial system approach, sustainability means another thing. And for a human evolutionary approach, sustainability means another thing. So, and again, sustainability and justice do not go hand in hand in human realities.
I would now love to hear from some of you, like, what are your main findings, main thoughts on the question.
And we were saying, the local community, to what extent are they going to benefit from these resources? So maybe what share would they benefit from?
I mean, what would be measures you could take in place to make sure that the local communities, they would actually benefit?
The structure of the summer school is different from normal summer schools. Normal summer schools have papers, lectures, and discussions. But we put a lot of emphasis on small group engaged breakout sessions.
It's very interactive between the lecturers and the students. They are very alive and interactive with us.
I'm mostly here for the engaging conversations. Like, once you get exposed to a fascinating group of people such as this, you really learn a lot in a very short time.
You know already that Potsdam Summer School is not only about gaining knowledge, It's also about meeting new people and broadening your perspective. And this is what we're gonna start with now.
The atmosphere is supposed to be very open and welcoming and warm, because we do have a lot of cultures here meeting people from different perspectives, and we want to create a situation where they really feel safe to show themselves and to form these connections.
In the field of art, you have your own ways of seeing, of thinking patterns. And it's very interesting to confront those ways of thinking and seeing the world with academic or scientific ways of seeing the world. And what would be fantastic if some of the participants feel like they could also get engaged with artists or with people from the field of the humanities.
To be honest, this is the best experience I've ever had in my life. I've been able to learn a lot in the summer school. How art helps in fighting climate change, how physics and chemistry helps in fighting climate change, how traditional communities can help in fighting climate change. And I look forward to more discussions into the future.
Seeing that unfortunately the governance level is failing on achieving the ambitious policies that we need, and I think on a global scale and on many local and national levels, it's really social movements that are fighting for a change and achieving important small victories so far.
Change will need to be driven by the younger generation. And I think that is important also to sensitize the younger generation about the type of challenges that we are dealing with, which hopefully will empower them to tackle and confront the socio-ecological crisis that we are facing head on with innovative solutions.
We share this motivation, still wanting to do something even though there is so much depressing environment around this.
We have very similar interests, and I think networking will make us stronger.